Today's topic is multi-stage rocket. We know that the rocket system works in the principle of conservation of linear momentum and Newton's third law. We already derived the velocity for the rocket system, so that velocity for the rocket system, at any time the velocity equals to the initial velocity which is given to the rocket system, and plus this is u, the velocity of a jet which is coming out through the nozzle, multiplied by log value of m naught, this is the initial mass of the rocket system, and divided by m, minus gt. So this is the equation for the velocity of the rocket here. So we can calculate the velocity at any time t here. Rocket is launched by igniting fuel and giving some initial velocity. Here the rocket is the example for variable mass system, as we know that when the gases are released, the amount of the fuel inside the chamber reduces. So this is a variable mass. But when it is moving up, rocket enters into the space by overtaking the gravity of the Earth. It has to overtake the gravitational force applied by the Earth. So it has to attain the velocity to escape the gravitational force of the Earth. So it has to attain the escape velocity. We know that escape velocity is equals to, here escape velocity, this is denoted by v, this is escape velocity, I'll write it as escape velocity. So this is almost 9.2 kilometers per second. So that rocket must attain this velocity to enter into the space by overcoming the gravitational force of the Earth, right? But initially, we have given some velocity V naught. V naught velocity is given to the rocket system. This is the initial velocity which is given to the rocket while launching. Then whether this initial velocity is equals to 11.2 kilometers directly, or this rocket attains this 11.2 kilometers after reaching some height, we have to know that. So when it is in the lab, the initial velocity given to the rocket system is almost this V naught value, which is equals to here 4 kilometers per second. Almost 4 kilometers per second. So this is the initial velocity which is given to the rocket system here. So this much velocity is not sufficient to escape the Earth's gravity. When it is moving up, it has to be accelerated. It has to be accelerated, means its initial velocity 4 kilometers, it is here, and its velocity should be increased after reaching certain height as time goes on. Then how to give the acceleration, how to produce the acceleration to the rocket? So this can be attained by manufacturing or preparing multi-stage rocket. So what is this multi-stage rocket? A rocket which is launched and which moves up vertically and whose mass is reduced stage-wise, almost generally in three stages. So three stages will be there. So in stage one, it will have some acceleration. In stage two, it will have some more acceleration, and in stage three Finally, it will attain 11.2 kilometers per second and enters into the space by overcoming the gravitational force, by escaping the gravitational force. So we have stage one, and stage two, every rocket will have stages depending on the purpose, maybe three or four. Suppose the rocket has three stages. So, we will discuss the first stage. So, this is stage one. So, in this stage, we have the initial velocity 4.2 kilometers per 10 second. The rocket is launched. So, the initial velocity is V naught. V naught equals to 4 kilometers per second, and it goes up with this velocity. Then after reaching some height, so after time t and reaching height will be what height it is reached with, again depends on the purpose of the rocket. So after some height h here, an amount of the fuel, so in this multi-stage rocket is actually having some compartments like that, an amount of the fuel is burned, and the complete in that container first attachment, the complete fuel is burned, and fuel produces the gases. So fuel is finished in that, and complete fuel is burned. Then the compartment is detached. So that part of the rocket system is detached. So it is detached from that one. Then mass is automatically reduced. So this is the first stage. So they have three stages, the rocket, and three separate compartments other chambers like that. So three chambers, they have the mass with the fuel. In the first stage, in the first compartment, when the total fuel is burned, that is detached from the rocket, then mass of the rocket is reduced after reaching a height. Then it will have acceleration. Acceleration is given to the rocket, and it will move with greater velocity than 4 kilometers per second. Velocity is greater than 4 kilometers per second. This is the first stage. So then coming to the second stage. So in the second stage, the same procedure. After launching the rocket, when it reaches to the second height, second stage, it will move with some more acceleration. So this acceleration again here increase when the fuel in the second compartment is completely burned. So even in the second stage also, so after reaching height, some other fuel is burned, and then so the mass is reduced here. Again, it will have acceleration. So this acceleration is increased here. So acceleration increased. Okay. And then third stage, coming to the third stage, maybe this is the final stage. So in this final stage, this rocket will attain that velocity which is equals to escape velocity which is equals to 11 kilometers per second. So every time some amount of the mass is reduced when the path is detached from the rocket. When it attains this escape velocity, 11.2 kilometers per second, it enters into the space. So then it will do its work here. So this is the multi-stage rocket, and the velocity is increased stage-wise. Directly 11.2 kilometers per second is now given to the rocket. After reaching certain height only, it will attain, and that height is in three stages here. So this is about how this rocket system escapes from the gravity.